Dear chess lovers, welcome back to my channel. Today the big match, the world championship match between the two giants, Magnus Carlsen and Ian Nepomniachtchi. This world championship series is happening in Dubai, one of the beautiful place. Everybody knows about the candidates match. Nepo wins the candidate tournament with all strong players like Caruana, Ding Liran and Grishuk. And successfully, Nepo assured his place to fight for world championship against the current world champion Magnus Carlsen. This is the first match. Nepo gets white pieces. He started with e4. Magnus replied with e5. Then regular moves, knight f3, knight c6, bishop b5. Spanish. After a6, bishop a4. Then knight f6. Here castle. After bishop e7, rook e1. Pawn b5. After bishop b3, castle. Here main move is c3. Surprisingly, Nepo played h3. Here why c3? Because the bishop on b3 is strong. Sometimes black tried to exchange his knight for bishop. For this reason, many players will play c3. c3 is a main move. But here Nepo played h3. Then after knight a5, there is a pawn on e5 is free. Here Nepo took the pawn on e5. After knight takes b3, a takes b3, bishop b7. Attacking the pawn on e4. Nepo supports with d3. Then d5. Here white must capture the pawn. So Nepo took. After queen takes d5, Nepo played queen f3. Here there is a checkmating threat. After getting one extra pawn, all players would like to exchange the queens. So Nepo played queen f3. Here immediately Magnus played bishop d6. Here there is a threat. In this position, Nepo played king f1. For example, if instead of king f1, if white plays some normal moves, then queen takes e5. White is losing the piece. Here white must capture the queen. Then bishop takes f3. Here white will lose the piece. For this reason, Nepo played king f1. Here Magnus played a rook fb8. Now queen takes d5. After knight takes d5, there is a small problem for white. Black is going to play knight b4. There is a c2 pawn is hanging. To stop knight b4, Nepo played bishop d2. Here c5. Then knight f3. Rook d8. Then knight c3. Now Nepo allowed their knight to b4. Here exactly Magnus played knight b4, then rook ec1, then rook ac8. Here knight e2, then knight c6, then bishop e3. After knight e7, this bishop has no square. Nepo would like to exchange the bishop on d6, so Nepo played bishop d6. Then bishop takes f3, after pawn takes f3, then bishop takes f4, knight takes f4, here the pawn on a6 is hanging. So Magnus played rook c6, then rook e1, attacking the knight. Now knight f4, idea knight to d4, try to attack the pawn on c2. Here Nepo stops black's plan with pawn c3, then knight h4, after rook e3, here king f8. Now knight g2. And then knight f5 again attacking the rook on e3. Now rook is attacking the knight on f5. Then pawn g6. Then knight g7. Rook e4. After f5. Then again rook e3. Now knight e6. Idea. Again knight is going to jump on f4. To stop this, Nepo plays knight g2. Here Magnus played the strong move. Please pause the video and try to find the very good move for black side. The move which is pawn b4, trying to open the queen side. There is some strong threats for black. Here Nepo played king e2. After rook b8, king d2. B takes c3. Here obviously king takes c3 is not good because knight will jump on d4. So Nepo took the pawn with pawn. After rook takes b3, king c2. Again rook is going to b7. Now h5. Idea. Trying to stop their king to g5. Now Magnus played king f7. Nepo played rook e1. After king f6, please pause the video and try to find the move for white. this move is not tactical, but the positional. If you're able to find the move, then it is very good. Here, if you find the reason why Nepo played a rook e to e1, because knight is ready to go on c4. If white knight is on c4, then the position is very good for white. For this reason, Nepo played a rook e1. After king f6, Nepo played a knight e3, then a rook to d7, and knight to c4. Now knight is ready to jump on d6, trying to give fork for two rooks. Here Magnus played a rook e7. After knight e5, Magnus cannot bring back his knight except this b6 and d6, because the pawn on a6 is hanging. So Magnus played a rook d6. After knight c4, again rook c6, knight e5, again rook d6, again knight c4. Here threefold repetition happens, then a draw. So first game of the World Championship match is drawn. We'll see what's going on next. I will try to post all the games. I hope you all enjoy the game. I will see you on next video.